I turn around to the yellow. Look it right here. Stop it. Oh my word. Fine marble base made in Italy. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rachel, aka Lilyworks, and you are viewing this video on my new sister channel. This one is called Lilyworks Antiques and Collectibles, and on this channel we are going to be shopping at Goodwill for things that are like antiques and collectibles. So my other channel is mostly all jewelry, vintage jewelry. Love selling jewelry, but I have now an antique booth and I've been doing a lot better with hard goods. So we're gonna do some shop at Goodwill videos, shop along with me. And I'm here in, where am I? Oak Creek, I think. Maybe Oak Creek, Wisconsin, or Franklin, Wisconsin, at a Goodwill. And I just dropped the girls off with Dad and Gideon. Gideon was dropped off with Dad too. We switched vehicles after gymnastics. We've had a long day, but guess what, you guys? I have a new phone. So I need to start making money to pay off this new phone. So hopefully we find some good things. Let's go thrifting. We're bringing in a cart from outside and it says, feeling lucky today, color is green. Ooh, there is like a Easter vignette that's happening right here. This basket is actually kind of cute with the pear tile. It says pear right there. Well, that is super adorable. It's holding a bunch of cards. I'm not sure if that's for sale, but that is really cute. I kind of like that. That'd be perfect for like a little spring decor in the booth. All right, we have a bunch of St. Patrick's Day stuff, scarf. All right, so I usually like to start over here where they like to display stuff because I think a lot of people might miss this hard goods section. A lot of people just go to the regular hard goods section right away. So I'm gonna check this out, see if anything catches my attention. We have this number 17. It's the Joseph Originals. These do not go for much. They're super cute though. We have a chicken creamer. That's cute. Oh, look at, we have a little match here. Would this be a sugar and creamer set? So this was for sale at St. Vincent de Paul. That's funny. And now it's here at Goodwill. What does it say? Might have said something like made in China or something. Don't mind my nails. You guys know, I like, if you watch my jewelry channel, you know, like we've had 4 days worth of sorting jewelry and now my orange is like a whole hot mess. It started off nice and now it's not. Okay, ooh, is this a vintage hat? It says Arlen 100% wool made in USA and it's $6.99. No, $6.99 is way too expensive for something like that. But I put a bunch of hats actually in the booth recently. All right, moving along. Ooh, another, it looks like another wool hat. Another wool, not branded. Let's see, anything down at the way bottom. There's this flash on color onto the glass. Oh, here's some glass, I think, with the Adventurine. That's really pretty. Let's see. Okay, actually, at first it looks like ceramic, but it's not. It says it's $19.99, but it's half off, you guys. It's the green. You can see it has a bit of a polished bottom. So, I'm going to try to do this with one hand. Nope, I'm going to turn off the camera and see if I can figure anything out about this. Okay, so the brand is MMCI, which is actually not a really great brand for reselling online after I looked up what is selling on eBay. So I'm going to leave that, even though it is really, really pretty on the top. It just wouldn't go in my booth. Obviously, it's modern. And yeah. Oh, look at this little chicken, though. Look at him. Interesting. We have, is this Pyrex, maybe? Let's look at this print. Nope. Something. Cute little print. Okay. Moving on. Does this spin? No. If that spun, that would have been awesome. Recycled glass, I think. $10. That's super cute. It's Avon Skin So Soft Bath Oil. Interesting. This is really pretty. I actually really like this a lot. Oh my gosh. It is metal. So what does it say? May poison food, $4.99. That is so pretty. You know what? I'm in love with that color. I love it. It's probably not like vintage, like old vintage, but I'm in love with that color so much. Okay, I think we're done with this curated section. We can move on. Alright, we are in like a mug section. What does this say back here? It says made in Germany. It's a little Germany piece. It's pretty. It has some of the lusterware is missing right there. We have more lusterware back here. Little boy and girl, it looks like. Look at this. Look at this wood. What is it, a wood tree? Oh, you could put little things in it? That's really cute. Let's see what this looks like. All right, $4.99. Is this a tree? Oh, I love that. Maybe it could be like a jewelry case or something. Put little rings in here or something. That is really cute. I think I'll grab that. We have little leaves with painted flowers. What are these? Japan. Those are really sweet. All right, moving down. What is up here? I really like that I can be tall and see everything pretty clearly at the top shelf. What is this? I actually really like this pattern. Pioneer Woman. I think that's pretty. This is like an artisan, well, I guess I shouldn't say artisan, hand painted. Someone made it. SR. Oh, these are cute. Look at these. Little basket weave. Does look hand painted. Oh, Sonoma. Interesting. I would have not guessed that. Okay. Keep moving. We have a rooster. Not sure about that one. More roosters. There's a lot of roosters today. What is this? Oh, broken. Okay. These are so sweet. Look at this silver edge vintage. So sweet. What are you? All right, this says Homer Law Laugh something, Virginia Rose, made in USA. I'm gonna look these up. There are three. We'll see if these are worth anything. They're really sweet cottage core. Cute. Okay, those plates did not turn out to be anything. Look at how cute. Artist signed right there. What does it say? Something. It looks very mid-century. We are definitely gonna grab that. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. All right, I feel like we're in a good spot to find some things. Aw, little precious moments on the bottom here. Let's move this out of the way. Yeah, that's super sweet. It says Precious Moments by Inesco. I am not going to pick that up. I usually don't pick up Precious Moments anything. But that was super sweet. Okay, moving. Actually, this is, looks like art pottery. I'm just gonna try to move things out of the way really quick just to check it out. Let's move that. Move the pecan pie. I love my pecan pie. I honestly think that pecan pie is my favorite pie. It, like with ice cream, oh my gosh. All right, let's not drop this. Tuscany Fields, not an artisan piece. Right, we'll put that back. Okay. Oh, what's this? Oh, this is a big crack. It is, but that would have been so neat. So rustic. Oh, this is one of those vintage kid sets that you put hot water on in and it keeps it hot and it's half off. I will grab that. That would be fun for the booth. Yay, we have a few things today. Vintage wheat pattern. We have a heart crock. What is this? Oh, another half off. Well, let's see what it is. Crocks can do well, especially if you like build up the vignette around it. So it says Crock Shop, Santa Ana, California. Okay, this is gonna be a yes. All right, we have some things. Yay. Is this a ceramic? Yes, it's a ceramic popcorn bowl. More chickens, more ceramic. Well-kept collection. Cute little teapot. All right, let's move down. Aw, a little tea set. Oh, look at how cute this is. Okay. What is that back there? What in the world? Something. It is fused together, so it might be like a chip and dip swirled art glass. Are you signed? You want to look on the edges. Oh, TJ Maxx. I like looking right past the TJ Maxx sticker. Yeah, you do want to see if a piece is artist signed. It will be like etched along the side usually. And that was interesting. Oh, I do like this print though. That teal blue is so pretty. One of those metal glass mugs. What is this big thing? A false graph. Ooh, look at this mid-century looking plate. I love the pink. That's really pretty. Do we have any more? Oh, another false graph. Kind of wish that there was more. I'm gonna put it in the cart just in case. Right here. And then we have more glass that's just flashed on. Let's see. Is this like a vanity crystal thing? Not vintage though. So, what's this? Did I miss this? Yeah, art pottery. Not pretty enough though for what I like to pick up. What in the world? Yeah, someone totally did the DIY thing right there. Maybe like a handmade bird bath. Okay, we have a stein that is actually unetched. $4.99. I'm not gonna grab it though. I don't think it's vintage. Okay. Let me know if you guys see anything that I've missed. This is actually really pretty. And I like that it's all saran wrapped together. Really, Better Homes and Gardens. That is a no. Trash can. We are almost to the end, you guys. Well, we'll start up here. You know what? I think that this, the other set of this is at another Goodwill. So I think this is like the Knott's Berries canister sets. Yeah, and there's another piece at the other Goodwill. That one says cherry pie. Another, like, is this another crock with a lid? Let's see. Let's move that. Doesn't say anything. I mean, it's pretty. I'm gonna leave that. And what is this vintage looking thing back here? Something. Again, it's half off, so I think it's worth just taking a look just in case. So this is Corral. Okay. That is a no. We'll put that one back. This one looks like it might be hand painted. Maybe. Oh, maybe Italy. Oh, big cracks. Look at that. It's the terracotta, the hand painted redware. Terracotta. Nope, not marked. So I'm gonna leave that pie plate. We have this like dough bowl. Is that what this is? This is Family Heritage Stoneware, the Pampered Chef. Yeah, this is a biggin. My cousins were from South Illinois and they would say a biggin. No way. What? $12.99 each? I'm gonna look these up. These are actually glass and orange. They're $12.99 each. Let's see. Yeah, $12.99 each. I'm gonna look them up. Like, these are just so fantastic. Orange, definitely not my color, but somebody's color. And I have candlesticks like this at home. Obviously, it's like clear. I've never seen this. We're gonna look that up. All right, so yes, this is a hand-carved like incense burner, and I believe it's soapstone after I looked at it a little bit more, and that makes sense because it has like elephants and things on it. All right, let's put that in here. There we go. All right, what's this? Pottery, nope, Crate and Barrel. This one says Crystal Votive Mikasa. Okay. Anything back there? Little bell. Oh, we're in the box section. There's a ton of little houses, and then we have dolls here. So you guys, I am, ooh, what is this? Oh, I thought that was a box. I am starting up another district site just for us here. We're going to be able to sell antiques and collectibles on that one, and I have just been seeing so many good things from District, and I can see the potential as far as using like social media and being able to advertise yourself on social media and being able to be a part of a bigger group, like if you want a live sale. So I was like, okay, we need to expand this a little bit because we have the jewelry district. And I thought it would be great to have the antiques and collectibles. So I did ask Sienna and she gave me the okay. I just have to She has to like put all the information in. I already created a lot of things for it already. There's a Facebook group for it. So if you guys don't know, it's our Facebook page where we're going to be able to advertise, called Lilyworks Antiques and Collectibles on Facebook. That's going to be the same thing as Lilyworks Jewels and Lots, and we're going to be able to advertise May Bouquet Candle for Mom. All right, I'm not seeing a ton of really interesting. Oh, I like this though. Look at it, there's paper and then there's pencils here at the top. Love that. So cute. All right, we have more figurines. That's a really pretty, like, iris. So pretty. This feels like Capodimonte space for like a something. Oh wait, there's the N with the crown. That is Capodimonte, isn't it? I don't know. Sometimes it's hard to. Yeah, there's like a tiny little bit of chip right there. That's really pretty. $1.99. We'll grab that. I think the N with the crown is Capodimonte. What is this? Little bitty fruits and vegetables. Oh my gosh. Oh, they're magnets. Yeah, I want these. No, this one's missing. Oh, here it is. But is it broken? What's the deal here? Yeah, it's a broken one. Oh well, I'm gonna put a new magnet on that. That is so, so cute. We'll grab that. All right, anything else? Okay, moving on to this one. Here's this lady. Oh, she does have like the Dresden lace look right here and right there. Are you Dresden? No, I mean, it feels a little like, I don't know what the term is, salty? A little bit more rough? I don't know. Are they covering the mark? All right, we'll leave her. Okay. Moving down. We have this pot. Wait, is this, what I think it is? Is this a butterbell? Is this a butterbell, you guys? Look. Oh, I think we have a butterbell. Oh my gosh, yay! Okay, that's just a part of the glaze. That's not a little nick, so that is a definite yes. Yay, we got a little butterbell and it's all together. What is this guy? An elephant, and I think he's meant to hold toothpicks. Oh, he's so stinking adorable. 99 cents. Yes, yes, yes. Look at his eyeballs. Oh my word. Wait, another magnet right there. Thank you. We have like a whole grocery store going on here. Are there any more stuck on the magnet? What is this? Is this another magnet? Wondering if there's supposed to be a battery in here and it might sound like a woodpecker. I'm gonna grab that. I have a display, as you guys know, I have a display where I have magnets up that are like Wisconsin magnets. That's really pretty. I'll get that one. That'll be cute to have like little vintage magnets mixed in. You guys know, this looks like Jim Shore, doesn't it? Nope, not Jim Shore. You guys know that I have been, oh, she's so sweet. Isn't she? I think she's a little vintage sweet thing. Let's see, what does she say under? Oh, look at this, look at it's pulling up the words. Boo, we're gonna leave that. What was I saying? Oh, I wanted to make like clip-on earrings into magnets and sell them there. We have another chicken. It's the time of the chickens. More dolls. All right, let me make it over to the plates. And sometimes at this store, they put in plates that are actually like fused glass plates or interesting tiles, not just like collector's plates. So I'm gonna look through here. So you guys, look at this plate. The giving plate. This plate has no owner. Its journey never ends. It travels in the circle of our family and friends. Enjoy this plate's contents and fill it up again and pass it along the love it holds to your family and friends. And now it's here. It said this, the journey never ends. Oh, that is so sad because someone was like, friends and family, I don't care. We're just going to end it here. Bless us all. We have something under here. Happiness. Mother plate. We have a nutcracker in there. Oh, I'm sorry. Fish. Okay, so we're in like the holiday aisle, and this looks like something that would be perfect to put in the booth for fall. It is probably a hobbyist piece. Do you put a light in it? Let's see. You do, you put a light and it probably glows in the background. It is marked MD on the back. We're gonna get that. How much is this actually? $4.99, yes, we'll get that. Put it right in here. That would be an absolute, like if you put a light in that, which I have a lot, that would just look so cool in a booth. All right, I think that's the only vintage piece I see here. I'm not even sure what holiday we're in right now, to be honest. Oh, Jim Shore. I see a Jim Shore box down here. It says, what, $15? Okay, and what are you? Does it show the picture? Might have to take him out. Okay, so he is the Nice Santa. And I did look him up on, like, using my Google Lens. Someone is selling this one for $22 on eBay. So that's just, you know, not enough for me. Some Jim Shore pieces can go for a lot, and I've actually sold a new, like, Easter set for, I think, like, almost $100 or maybe even over $100. And it was from, like, an Amazon return store. All right, let me try to get this in and keep going. Okay, we're still in the holiday section, and look at how adorable this is. This is like a little boy in a barber's chair with a little barber pole. That is so cute, $2.99. Yes, that is so stinking adorable. He's like worried for his hair. I like these little egg things. We have the grass, we have a bunny. Oh, this is a cutie little basket. We have a broken bunny. Anything else? A little doll. What is that? Picture thing. And more precious moments down there. So I'm in this pink section, and you know what I think this is? I think this is a yarn bowl. I think. $1.99 half off. Oh my gosh, how could I resist? Hand painted. A little bit of crazing right there, but you would put your yarn through here, and the ball would stay in there, so that it, like the ball, like if you ever knit or crochet and you start unraveling a ball, it just starts rolling everywhere as you pull. So that's what these are for. So we're gonna get that one. So cute. And then what else do we have in the pink section? Pink is my favorite. We have like cranberry trees. Oh my gosh, I'm kind of obsessed. There's like sugared berries in there. $2.99. You know what? This would be so cute, like for myself. I love these. Oh my word. Okay, those are maybe. We'll see about those. And then down here, this is just, this is not in the glass. It's like on the outside of the glass. Pink, like depression color. What is this? What is this? Oh, there's something in there. What is that? Candle? Patent applied candle warmer. Okay, put that right there. That pot is too far gone. And then, what is this? Oh, a little tea set in there. Cute. All right, moving up. Oh, so sweet. Vintage pink gravy boat, maybe? More chickens, you guys. This is a carved wood chicken. We'll get the carved wood chicken. Where can we put him? Put him down here. What else? Ooh, this is really pretty. Oh, Chippy's at the top, so that's a no. We have a Star Wars theme coming up. So what does this say? This will be a day long to remember. Love. This feels like art glass, honestly. Trinket tray. Ooh, is this a little crock? It says Preston 78. There's a little Chippy right there. What is this? Look at this cutie little cup. Probably like 24 karat gold on the outside. Wooden pepper grinder. What is this? Says Stoneware Factory, the Great American Stoneware Factory. I'm gonna Google lens these. There's two of them. Are they ashtrays? What are they? Okay, right in front of my face is like a, I don't know, like a root beer brown amber, root beer brown amberish color liquor bottle, vintage, half off. We'll grab that. I'll put that in the glass, or the window section of my booth. American Landscapes tin. This is a barrel. I hear things in the inside. What does it say? Commemorative edition McCor something. Let's see. Okay, so apparently this is a McCormick whiskey holder. This feels like teak wood or monkey pod, a little sand dollar. Some canisters. Not sure what that says. Ooh, look at this though. That's really pretty. Art pottery. Love this. I love this. This is some handmade art pottery. Candlestick. Yes. I love that. I don't even care that there's only one. That's just fantastic. All right. What else? I still can't figure out what these are, to be honest. What is this? Okay, we need this art pottery piece as well. I don't know if it's signed, but it's only $2. Little trinket dish with a leaf. Oh my gosh, so neat. I like love art pottery so much. Okay, what is this guy? He belongs with something. Pioneer Village. That's cute. Okay, moving down. Birds. A wooden, look at how pretty that wood is though. Wood mug, that is lovely. Oh, I've sold this guy before. We're gonna put him in the booth if he's a reasonable price. Yeah, we'll get him. He's so cute. All right, so I found this in the brown section right here, and it has like that really deep, nice Italy stamp. Someone has it for as like 1980s. I'm not even sure if that is, but it's going for like $40, and this is half off of $7. Oh, get that. Let's see. Highmark kitchen. Okay, we will get that and sell it on eBay. Anything else? Oh, I did see that there were some coasters right here, Costa Rica. So we'll leave those. Here's a brown vintage piece. What are you? Let's pull it out. This one is cover proof, and this is a hull pottery. And we are in blue. This looks very similar to blue onion. Not, what is this? $24.99. What are you? Is it something fantastic? Might just be from China. I don't know. We'll leave that. I think it's not marked that I can see. Ooh, look at how cute this little pottery piece is. I think it's marked, maybe. Whatever that is, RA, maybe. 99 cents. I like this one. There's a sun piece. We'll leave it here. It's a little, like, not polished enough. Milk bottle. I do like these vases. I have enough of those, though. Oh, this is pretty, isn't it? Then we have, this is another Pfalzgraf. Okay. That's a really pretty cobalt blue. Okay. I turn around to the yellow. Look it right here. Stop it. Oh my word. Fine marble base made in Italy. No. How much is this one? Does it even say $24.99? Oh my gosh. We have like a whole, we're gonna like price it at like $150. This whole set here. No, we have like a whole set, you guys. That is so exciting. And then what is this? Is this a salt? No, it's too big. What is this? Parmesan cheese? Well, this is cool with a little thumbprint thing. I'm just so excited about those orange things. Ah, that's just so exciting. Okay, we have perfume. Midnight pomegranate. Okay. I think that's it from here, but that was a really awesome find. I'm gonna look up, what is this? I'm gonna look up this thumbprint one just to see, but yeah. All right, I am going to head over here to see if there's any vintage wallets or purses or anything like that. Smaller the better in my opinion. That feels like fake. Tooled leather. Nope, nothing over there stands out. Actually just sold a Lucky Brand bag this past week. What is this one? $6.99. What does it say? Soul Society. That's a no. All right, more wallets and small-ish bags. Sometimes you can find like Whiting and Davis, little Kisslock purses, little petite point or petty point bags. Here's something. Let's see if this is vintage. Are you? Let's see if it's made in Hong Kong or Japan. This is not saying anything. I mean, it's kind of cool how it folds over, but I don't think that it is vintage. I don't really see wear on it. I don't know. Maybe it's just really excellent shape. Here's another fully beaded. Here we go. What does this say? This one says made in Japan, $2.99. And this one is missing, is it? Where did I see it? Yeah, maybe not. Oh, right there. Right there, it's missing a little bit. It feels so nice though, the fully beaded look. Oh, look at this boho thing. This one is Express. That's a no. Okay, moving on. Little purse. What is this up here? Little travel purse. Vacation purse. Okay, I think we're done with purses. Let's keep going. Okay, so we're in Pillows. looking for some vintage. Here is a velvet back. This is pretty. Tapestry. Half of $2.99. A little bit of stuff. I think that it definitely is vintage though. I'm gonna leave it though. I'm not big on selling pillows. Oh, but there is a match. There's a pair. Now I'm kind of considering it. I could just sell it in the booth like as is. Little vintage pillows. Oh, there's a little stain on here. Okay, we're gonna leave them. If it was actually like hand sewn Petit Point, uh-oh, what is this? A deer pillow. Oh my gosh, look at how stinking adorable this is. It's like a puffy deer with mushrooms. It is like really thick. Oh my gosh, someone handmade it and like really stuffed it, like really, really stuffed it. I'm gonna consider this. This is pulling at my heart, and it's like one of those things where you're like, oh my gosh, that's so, I mean, his eyeball's a little in the crack, but he's really cute. Okay, last things last, we're coming back to the green and I have my black light. We're just going to hit everything with the black light since it's all green. And we'll see if anything glows uranium, because I have this idea. I have an idea of like putting a black light in one of the curios that I just got, and then it would feature. This is kind of cute though. Look at this. This is cutie. What is this? Brunswick, Germany. Oh my gosh, that is so cute with the green. $2.99. All right, let's focus. No. Well, this is also really cute. Jen did that one. Okay. And so when people see it like all glowing and stuff, they're gonna be drawn into the booth. All right. Oh, wait, what about this one? $14.99. Why is this $14.99? Is this a glower? It doesn't look like it. I don't know. I don't think so.
Attention customers!
All right, you guys, that is that. I just made it home. I spent a total of about $100, just a tiny bit over $100. I think it was like $113, and I got $13 off because of the points that I accumulated through the Southeast Wisconsin Goodwill Rewards Program that they have. So I did save a little bit of money, and actually I think I did pretty good, $100 for everything. And I'm going to be pricing just that orange Hollywood Regency like crystal set for over $100. So that right there is great. And if you would like to see like how these things are selling, what things I choose to put online, how the booth is doing, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Trying to grow this channel as quickly as possible just to make sure that we get to the monetized area. So that's over 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. Also, it helps with our new Lilyworks Antiques and Collectibles platform, so more eyeballs are on our sales platform. So yeah, make sure you subscribe. Hit the like button on your way out. Leave me a comment down below. It always helps the channel get seen. And as always, make sure you're out there thrifting so you guys can live generously. Bye, guys. A huge shout out to all the Patreon members for supporting both YouTube channels and our Lilyworks Facebook community. Come on over to our new selling platform called district.net. We have two stores. One is called Lilyworks Antiques and Collectibles. The other is Lilyworks Jewels and Lots. Become a member. You can also become a seller. Also, if you're interested in anything you see from this video or reseller merch, go ahead and head over to lilyworksreseller.com, where you can find different collections for sale. Also, make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!